I started into ornithology really as a bird watcher. I get excited to wake up in spring mornings to see what new birds are on the landscape. I work in the field of aeroecology. So aeroecology is the study of migratory birds, bats, and insects and their use of airspace. So we work really hard to understand what's going on in the airspace as a critical habitat. And especially at night, that's when the vast majority of birds are going to take flight. And as we know, airspace is increasingly becoming modified. So that might be wind turbines or light pollution at night. We largely focus on using radar data. So the same radars that you might look at the Weather Channel, for instance, to look at, is it going to rain? Those data are also collecting things about migratory birds. So we host these forecasts for spring and fall migration, hoping that that will motivate conservation action as well. If folks can know with some lead time that there's going to be a tremendous pulse of migratory birds, that might be a cue to say, turn off your lights at night to protect these migratory birds, or the potential of halting the rotation of a wind turbine on a specific night in a specific area could really help these birds. It's sort of a small selection of nights that are really important for migratory birds. So we might say spring migration lasts for 100 days, for instance. But of those 100 days, about 10 nights equate to about 50% of the movement. So if we can really target those nights, and that's where this forecasting piece comes into play, if we can target those 10 nights to motivate action, we can really refine these estimates versus saying, halt your wind turbine for 100 days or halt your lights for 100 days. We can target very specific nights in spring and fall to have targeted conservation action.